Morning students, so today we'll explain the chapter Shehnai of Bismillah, right? So students, Emperor Aurangzeb banned the playing of a musical instrument called Pungi in the royal residence, for it had a shrill, unpleasant sound, right? So here banned means prohibited. Prohibited means to stop. Nobody was allowed to play Pungi, right? And meaning of shrill is very sharp. Very sharp means the sound that was very sharp. And unpleasant means something that you dislike. So Pungi was a musical instrument, the predecessor of the Shehnai. Predecessor means that comes after Pungi. Okay, when the Mughal ruled India, do you know who was Aurangzeb? Aurangzeb was a Mughal ruler, right? And when the Mughals ruled India, before the Britishers came, there was a very famous Mughal ruler named Aurangzeb, right? Mughal ruler whose name was Aurangzeb ruled over India before the Britishers came, right? He did not allow the Pungi be played in his royal residence because he felt that it had a shrill, unpleasant sound. Because he always think about the Pungi, that the sound of Pungi is not good, right? So he banned the instrument Pungi, right? Pungi became the generic name for reed noisemaker. Okay, generic name, a name given to a class or group as a whole, right? Generic name means the scientific name or a broad classification of something. Generic means not good, not real. Okay, reed means wind instruments which have reed, like the flute and cornet, etc. Right? So any musical instrument which is made with reed, like we have flutes, cornets, they all are classified as Pungi. So Pungi is a broad term for any types of instrument which used wind to produce sound. Right? So we had thought that it would one day be revived. Revived means to brought back to life. Okay. As Aurangzeb has banned all these reed noisemakers, he had banned Pungi in his royal residence. Residence means the palace where he used to live. No one thought that one day such noisemakers, such instrument which made unpleasant sound, would be played and their sound would be liked by the audience, right? At the time of Aurangzeb, nobody was able to thought that after some times that Pungi get revived. Okay, a warbler of a family of professional musicians who had access to the royal palace decided to improve the tonal quality of the Pungi. Tonal quality means sound. As the Pungi had an unpleasant sound, there was a warbler who belonged to a family of professional musicians, and he wanted to play the Pungi, but he knew that the sound produced by Pungi was unpleasant, and so he decided to improve the sound. Who decided to improve the sound? Ustad Bismillah Khan. He chose a pipe with a natural hollow stem that was longer and broader than the Pungi, and made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. Hollow means empty from inside. This barber took a pipe which was a hollow stem. It was longer and broader than the Pungi. He made 7 holes on the body of the pipe. If you have seen a flute, it is something like this. It is a pipe which is hollow from inside and has hole on it. Right? When we played on it, closing and opening sound of these holes, soft and melodious sounds were produced. Then he blew air into the pipe and closed and opened different holes. He found that soft and melodious sounds were produced when he did like this. Okay. He played the instrument before royalty and everyone was impressed. When the warbler played this instrument like pungi in the royal court, everyone liked the sound produced by it. The instrument so different from the pungi had to be given a new name. The royal court thought that this instrument was different from the pungi and so it should have a different name also. As the story goes, since it was first played in the Shah's chambers and was played by a Nai means barber, the instrument was named by Shehnai. Due to Nai, its name was Shehnai. Okay. Now there is a story behind the name given to this instrument. What was the story? This instrument was played for the first time in the royal residence of the Shah. Shah was a name given to king. Right? Mughals called the kings as Shah. As the Nai. Nai means barber. That is the Indian term used for a barber had played it for the first time. They called it Shehnai. Shehnai. Shah means Shah is the name of a king and Nai means barber. So the first part is Sheh, which stands for Shah. And the second name, Nai, that is a barber. So this instrument was named as Shehnai. Okay. Students, this chapter is divided into part. So we read first part. So second part we'll discuss later. Okay. Take care.